What's going on, people? It's Kenny Allstar, the general. You already know my ting. This is how I DJ. Take me in.
You so hot on the web until catch him. Lack it. We gon' run down. We ain't gon' clap him. We gon' smack him. We know that you ain't about action. All of you is acting. Gun fingers in the camera.
I'd say I started properly maybe the summer of 2010. So a lot of my friends used to go to a lot of house parties. And at this point, I'm still in that school. I wasn't allowed. My mom was proper strict. But I remember when I went to my first house party, it was like such a vibe. So dancehall music was like the thing. So I would be listening to the DJs, the sound systems, play and juggle dancehall music, bashment music, you know. And I was really inspired by just the ability to speak, interchange with records, like tell a story through the records that they play in their set. And I remember the first time I saw that, I was like, I want to do that. A good technique that I like to do in the clubs is, again, with BPMs being different from genre to genre, I think the power is always in my speech. So anyone that's seen me live will know I'll play like a record. I don't know. Let me look for a random dancehall record. Extra lesson. Let's say I got a record like this. Extra lesson.
Extra.
So at this point, when I get to a dancehall set, the whole place is already a zoo. That's the way we do it. But what I like to tend to do is seamlessly flow from genre to genre. So I'll let this one for a little bit. Don't judge me, this is what I do. I do a lot of talking on the mic. And then sometimes I'm like, vibing. Dancehall's going off, I think, alright, cool, I'm gonna go over to the UK. So we let the chorus run. Always let the best part of any record run. Any up and coming DJs understand that you, no one likes a record cut short. That's just the way it is. So I usually go from dancehall to the UK, and I'll probably do it like this. So yeah, the girls like whining to Kenny Allstar, what can I say? We're one of the hottest in the clubs. But you know what's so mad? Every time the girls tell me that I'm one of the sickest DJs in the club, I always find myself in a trust issue.
I don't trust anybody.
And then it's like, you know, a bit more smooth. A bit more smooth like that. But then that's what I was trying to show you earlier. Stories for me is everything. Like, that's what connects records to me. You know, being able to say one thing about one song and then there we go, we've got a genre change just off the back of me saying something about trust issues and a girl, which is probably not true. Or maybe it is. Probably maybe a couple weekends after that moment, I went to my first rave. Yeah, at Dreams Nightclub, NW10. And I saw, again, more sound systems, very influenced by Jamaican dancehall DJs and just that whole vibe. And then probably around that summer, definitely, I had my first DJ set at Dreams and I never looked back, you know. I came up with a lot of radio DJs. And a lot of people will hear the list that I'm about to go through and think, how? Like, that's weird. I used to listen to Pete Tong, Judge Jules, Annie Mack, Trevor Nelson. Complete inspiration to me. Always knew that seeing someone that looked like myself coming through on radio, Radio 1 at that, was always incredible. So I look up to people like him. Again, those kind of Radio 1 DJs, because if it wasn't Radio 1, then it was Pirate, that on Top FM and Rinse and whatever frequency I could get that would play like grime or anything that replicated the sound of my generation. I was in love with that. I'm a big fan of quick mixing, and I think with it being normal in dancehall to mix quick, it's kind of against the rules to do that with hip hop. You know, I remember an old, I don't want to say older DJ, but a DJ before me always said, Kenny, you mix too fast.
how will people be able to understand? But with the audiences getting younger in the nightlife scene, everyone's got a low attention span. Everyone's on their phones. They get bored quick. So I think my job every time I play out is to make sure you're not bored. All right, cool. You've had enough of that song. Cool. We're on to the next one. So this, for example, let's go with this like that.
Go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna go off the deep end. I don't think you wanna go
My body different. Shorty said she tryna kick it. I'm in the mouth, son, like a dentist. Cooking up, I'm in the kitchen. Big boy,
so it's all about quick mixing with me. Like, I'm just already thinking about
now I'm back, game boy, the next look, one. And I'm doing well. Don't even ask how I'm living. Stay real, they cap. Ride around with the sea laid back. They told me to chill, I'm itching the clock. If I pull up, somebody get whacked. Boy, tire lace is tripping. Red lights, we gon' skip it. Up a new V, we was dipping. From the police, I was drilling. Then let's skate on. Run up a bag with my bro guards. Watch how I show off. Step in the room and she taking her clothes off. I ain't even say much. Can't even do much. They like stiff you too much. No, I got a bag, bro. No, I live a fast life. Boobs. Baddie, baddie, boo.
You see that? Transitions. It's all about getting like that gap to kind of just flex, you know what I mean?
Pop out Balenciaga. I'm hot like lava. Drop 10 bands on Prada. Free frosty lava.
The instruments in drill music, the hi-hats, it can easily take a mix off, even if you've got Serato record box or things to kind of help you. So I think it's all about the timing, you know? So we're in the hook right now. Trying to find the next one.
Deja is such an important, like being part of Pirate Radio was such an important come up. Nowadays, I say the same about community radio stations. Like represent radio, big part of my come up. Stations like that, Rinse, Rest, Westside, there's so many stations that focus on underground and the next generation. And without those radio stations, there's no way that I think any DJ could make it onto like a Radio 1 or 1 Extra in a time like this. You know what I mean? I remember watching Dizzy and Crazy Titch on the Roof, you know? That for me is everything. I remember watching Lady Fury and Wiley and Trim all going back to back on the roof. So that was my thing. I was like, I gotta be on that. And I set my heart to get there. Even though I had to blank my way in, I got there in the end. So I was doing weekend breakfast shows and I was just doing multi-genre mixes, like just playing anything that I really was listening to at the time, from dancehall to a bit of grime, old school garage, anything just to keep the people moving. I was a part of that.
So what I want to do right now, I want to go through instrumentals that I've played for Mad About Bars that I've picked for artists. And then I'll literally just do a instrumental mix so you get a vibe. Like, some of these instrumentals is crazy. With drill, is so much different than like grime. In grime, the DJ leads the set. The DJ is in charge of the set and you follow the DJ's lead as a grime MC. In drill is completely different because rappers in the genre write to songs and individual instrumentals. where a grime MC might just write 64 bars and that could be used on any instrumental. So I think for me, I try my best to have that element of surprise, slowly working a record, you know, slowly easing the track. And I try my best to make the instrumental as close to the record that they have written for. So let's say, for example, a rapper has written for the Heady One Rose Gold instrumental. I might find a Y Pre instrumental by Millions because it has the similar beat patterns, similar instrumental structure. So when I'm mixing it in, they don't stop and think, oh, what's this like? You know what I mean? Because no matter how smooth a mix is, if someone's not used to the set structure and just go into a grime set or radio set and just rapping over different beats, it's gonna be very hard for them. Dancehall sound effects are some of the best sound effects. Laser horns and glass smashes and bombs. Believe it or not, the dancehall DJs, they know how to utilize that the most. So that's where I got a lot of my stuff from, just that. And sound effects do add to the atmosphere, you know? There's a difference between just playing a record and then playing a record that hits, and then you're hearing like a million and one glass smashes. You're thinking that, yo, this is it. My cue banks, my banks. So look, even the fifth sound effect, that would be a truck running past to go with the Voice of the Streets theme. People don't understand that sound effects can be part of a DJ's brand if it's used properly. You know, you got your normal tags. I got a Kenny All-Star tag, I got a Voice of the Streets tag, and I've got one extra Shellins tag. But then I got things like the ragga horn. If you hear me play dancehall, I might hit the ragga horn and it makes sense. If I hit the truck passing through as a transition, you know, for example, let me just give you a good example if you listen to my radio on a truck stop transition that I would do. So let's say I'm playing this instrumental, I'm about to mix another one. You're gonna hear how I use the truck stop transition and why that's so close to my brand. Just waiting for the drop to come. So truck stop. See, that is how I do it in a way where it's like, okay, truck moving, transition, Voice of the Streets, you get it. Think about it, you know what I mean? And then you got the iconic bomb drop that was used by so many greats over the years, like Funk Flex, Clue, Tim Westwood. That bomb, iconic. So these are how like the sound effects just add to my whole vibe. And I take that very serious. If you listen to me on the radio, you'll know I take drops serious, I take sound effects serious. And transitions are very important, as you know. There've been many times where I may have been off, like I've just not been on the ball, but again, I can use my voice and use kind of transitions to just piece mixes together. And in the conventional term of what a DJ, a disc jockey is, where you might watch someone like EZ and that's like the most incredible 30 minutes or hour you will ever see in your entire life. I'm not that kind of DJ, you know? I'm a DJ that kind of builds a journey. It's weird. I like to just do random things at times, and it's got to be one whole vibe that moves with you. You got to hear the voice. That's what comes with it. It's like a package, you know. It's like a PA. You know, I come and I play some of my records. I play what's hot, and then you'll hear me talk, and that's the whole experience of a set. So, yeah. My existence in this game as a DJ that loves DJ and that loves the music that I do, I'm only here because there are loads of artists that are so good at what they do. And that's it. Call me a backup dancer, call me the person that just presses the green button for people. I don't mind that, you know? I'm genuinely just in love with just this job. And now we're starting to get the credit for that, you know. I've got great people around me, great teams, and
you know, we're not really slowing down anytime soon.